coffee, reactions. What else could I ask for? How's it going, guys? It's Nate. I'm back with another reaction. Today I'm reacting to Ariana Grande and Justin Bieber, Stuck With You, official video. So go ahead and drive me insane. Baby, run your mouth. I still wouldn't trade me. And stuck with you, stuck with you, stuck with you. I'm stuck with you, stuck with you, stuck with you. Now this one came out a bit over a month ago. I added it to my React To playlist then, and never reacted to it. So I got it on here, I got it on deck. We'll see what we got with this. It is interesting to think about. Okay, if you look at even 20 years ago, now if you think about that, that was 2000, the year 2000. Even 15, 10 years ago, our world was a different place. I mean, the word racist wasn't thrown around as much. I mean, there's so many things that have changed, and not in a good way, in my estimation. And it's crazy because you can say, okay, 10, 15 years ago, that's a bit of time. Okay, how about 1 month? I am interested to see how this video, which is two famous pop stars that are in the limelight, how much it's changed from now to then, from then to now, in the current social climate. If there's anything in here that even in a month would be labeled a certain way. Now maybe there's nothing, but it's gonna be interesting because I feel like even a month ago, our social climate and social differences in political differences, anything like that, were so much different even just a month ago. So I'm gonna see. I'm interested to see what'll if there'll be anything. What will be different in this? Let's see. Let's just check it out. Load, man. Yeah. That's just for fun. What? I'm no one to stick around. One strike and you're out, baby. Don't care if I sound crazy, but you never let me down. No, no. That's why when the sun's up, I'm staying. Still laying in your bed, saying. It's awesome. We're going back to COVID, quarantine, just kind of that loneliness and that feeling of don't know what's going to happen next, but we're stuck here. I love it. It's written in that time, literally a month ago, of before all of the riots and protests and stuff, this was the big thing, the big issue going on. And this positive vibe that it's bringing with it is just awesome. I love it. Yeah.
I get to know you better. Kinda hope we're here forever. There's nobody on these streets. If you told me that the world's ending, ain't no other way that I can spend it. Oh, 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 oh. Got all this time in my hands. Might as well cancel our plans.
I love the good vibes of it. Like the love and the care that people have for each other. And the relationships, the healthy relationships, it's just a good vibe, and I like it.
Might as well cancel our plans. I can stay here forever. It's just you and me, and there's nothing I can do. I'm stuck with you, stuck with you, stuck with you. So go ahead and drive me insane. Baby, run your mouth. I still wouldn't trade being stuck with you, stuck with you, stuck with you. I'm stuck with you, stuck with you, stuck with you. All my time.
Go on, make me lose my mind.
We got all that we need here tonight.
I lock the door.
And
throw out the key. Can't fight this no more. Just you and me. And there's nothing I'd rather do. I'm stuck with you.
That organ, though, in the background, it's just riffing in the background. And also, I love all the different types of relationships that it's showing, even people alone, you know, the self-love. And then the animals, the kids, dad, son, mom, daughter, parents, husband, wives, boyfriend, girlfriend. I love it. It's just good vibes, really good vibes.
And drop me insane, baby, run your mouth. I still wouldn't change all this loving you, hating you, wanting you. I'm stuck with you, stuck with you, stuck with you.
Nice. That is awesome. Fundraiser type video / song. That's awesome. I like that. Yeah, just good vibes, and that was awesome. I think it's interesting because these type of situations that we've been going through for all of 2020, just one after the other, it really shows not only the human spirit, but the individual spirit and how and the American spirit, that we can go through these things and these hardships and these struggles and use them as a platform and a stair to becoming more close or learning or growing or being better, using these hardships and trials to become better people and better as communities and better as a country. And I think the whole of 2020, we've done that up to the George Floyd incident. I say incident, the George Floyd murder. That is where, so far, it's been used for political gain. It's been used. It's not been used to unite or grow or learn. And I know it can, and in areas it has. It started, here's the thing. In my estimation, it started conversations that we've needed to have for a long time. And that's huge, and that's awesome. Conversations are important. Communication is incredibly important, especially with issues that are so divisive and hard to talk about. However, here's the thing. In our current social climate, communication is actually being destroyed by the name-calling, finger-pointing games. And until we can stand up and say, this is my responsibility, take this on myself and change what's going on, every single one of us, that will continue and only get worse. So each of us doing what we can to enact good in the world, that is the only thing that is gonna change the world. Personal, individual, good. And I see it all around me, and I've seen it throughout all of 2020 and each of these situations, and even this situation, I've seen positive, just good. But there definitely is a lot of division and a lot of hate and a lack of willingness to change. And pointing fingers, blaming, lack of taking responsibility, and that until that changes, we won't get through this. So I think it's just individual, each of us looking at our own lives and looking at our neighbors with love, and each person we meet with love, and changing the way we're looking at these things. And I know that's skirting around a lot, but yeah, I don't want to get too deep into it, which, you know, I don't care to get this channel into political subjects too much, or controversial. Obviously a lot of these things hit on controversial subjects, especially with nowadays art. A lot of nowadays art focuses so much on political issues and current issues and stuff, which I think is, in the end, detrimental to art. But it does. So anytime it does, I'll touch on it, but I'll try not to go too deep into it. I enjoy conversation and discussion and learning, but the fact of the matter is, a lot of people are so set in what they believe and not willing to look at the truth, or not willing to look at anything other than what they already believe, that it's just a lot of times it's not conducive to good conversation, good communication, and actually growing and learning the truth. It's just not conducive to it. So I'm not willing to just argue or attack straw men of arguments, or, you know, it's just divisive and unproductive. So that's my stance. I try to keep things not as political and just keep things chill. That's the hope. Anyway, this is a great song. I loved the viewpoints and the love and the care that you see. That it's like, it's good to look back on that literally a month ago, when everybody didn't hate each other. You know, and that's not true, you know, obviously. But that's what the media and some people want you to believe. And personal experience will tell you something completely different. But if you listen to any of these people, we're headed down a dark road. Anywho, bright lights. Thanks so much for watching, guys. If you enjoyed this video, like, comment, and subscribe. Also, if you have any suggestions, drop them down in the comments. I would love to see what you guys are watching too and check it out. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in the next video. Peace. The thumbs up, yeah, just click it. I've got like 2 minutes of test footage just telling you to subscribe.